Yesterday, I was watching some of your YouTube videos. The one that really stuck out to me was the one that you talked about when you went to the Aces training camp, and then you were sharing kind of your experience with failure. But I liked how you turned it around and said, you know, it wasn't necessarily a failure. Could you walk me through maybe like what your WNBA experience is, what your goals are with that, and then how the ups and downs that have happened with that?
Yeah. So, okay, we'll start at the beginning. I got drafted in 2016 to Dallas. And I played there my rookie year. And like, even just like that training camp was the most intense experience of my life, because if you know the WNBA, you know that like there's very limited roster spots, like veteran turnaround is very rare. Like if you're drafted in the second round, like the odds of you making a team is like less than 1% or something crazy like that. And so I was drafted in the second round. It was 18th overall, I believe. And so I went to training camp and I was like, well, just got to leave it all on the court. And I managed to like make the team. Like the team even made a, like a trade for a center just to like make a spot for me.
Oh, wow.
And so, yeah, played my rookie year there. That was a really challenging experience though, because just the culture of the team that year was like really quite toxic in a lot of ways. Like we had a lot of dysfunction. And when you're like a rookie role player on a team that is operating at that level, it can be really stressful. And also
yeah, you can imagine
we're just like isolated. So that was a challenging experience. And then the next summer I decided to just like suspend my contract, so just like took a break in the year because I want to play for Team Canada. And because I've been one of those players on the bubble, I want to just actually spend my summer developing and getting better instead of sitting on the bench in Dallas. And so I was like, okay, I'm gonna just pause this so I can really just get some minutes and just continue to get better and hopefully increase my chances of making the Olympics. And so then the year after that, I was like, okay, well, there's a bit of time. Like, I think I can go back to Dallas. I went to the training camp and then I got cut. And so that was hard to get cut there. I mean, that's a big cut to like your ego and to like everything. And then the next year was the Aces training camp. And so I had this opportunity. And it's like, you never really know what your actual chances are. A lot of times those training camp contracts are like just mainly for training bodies while they wait for people to return from overseas. But I was like, okay, just going to go make the most of it. And I really just like put my heart and my soul into like preparing for that. And like, cause I wasn't overseas. I was in Vancouver. I was training at level 10 with John.
I've heard of level 10. I know some other athletes that go there.
Yeah. There were some snowboard girls there that I saw.
Oh yeah. Maybe yeah, like so Spencer O'Brien. I think she trained there. I don't know.
And then, yeah, so I went to that training camp and I definitely didn't, it wasn't my best performance, got cut. And that once again, that was just kind of like a real tough cut. And it's just because also like the WNBA is such an elite status, you know, it's like when you make a WNBA, like you've made it in your basketball career. And so I just wanted to like get back in there. And so that was tough. And just being able to dig deep into my character and like bounce back from that. And I just think also I really enjoyed sharing that journey and like kind of tying it back with my YouTube. Like my goal of my YouTube channel is to kind of like be really authentic in this like professional basketball life. And so not just showing the glitz and the glam and like highlight reels and stuff, but like, hey, this is like really hard. And like there's days where you don't feel like doing it and you push through, and just really showing like the whole realm of what it takes. And I think it was scary to post that video, to kind of like literally publicly declare like this failure, you know? I think it's such an important message, especially for young female athletes to see, because it's something that they don't see because it's just not shown. And it's like, okay, well, if I can use my vulnerability here, kind of find a little bit of strength from this just to like encourage some other young female basketball player who maybe got cut from her high school team or like whatever may have happened, to let her know like this happens, like this is very real. It doesn't define you, but like how you respond to it is what's going to define you. And so I just thought that was going to be an important message to share, as terrifying as it was to make a vlog that vulnerable. But yeah,